three straight to take the series. But as a player, you really can't think that way. It's time for that old baseball cliche. You gotta take them one game at a time, and that definitely applies right here and now.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next. The crowd is ready to erupt as their guys get set to take the field. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now your 2016 Chicago Cubs.
And briefly here, a glance at the two starters who'll get the ball here in this one. With that, here's a look at Terry Francona's Tribe starting nine. What do they need to focus on in order to win a championship here on the road, Steve?
Well, I think it's going to be really important to understand the pitcher that they're facing and make the adjustments as the game goes along. If this guy's in the zone, then be aggressive. Go up there hacking. But if he's trying to be effectively wild within the strike zone, then you got to be a little more patient and work the count.
John Lester will look to keep their World Series hopes alive on the mound. What's your take on him, EK?
Well, guys, remember, he's got five pitches to work with, so that really makes it difficult for the hitter. He can change speeds, ball moving in and out. Not a lot of fun for the hitters.
And with a quick breather here, let's take a look at the Cubs' alignment on defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, this former USD Torero, Chris Bryant, one of the best in the game offensively, doesn't get a lot of accolades for his defense, though. Can play any one of a number of positions, but really settling in comfortably at third base. He's got soft hands, he's got an excellent arm, very rare for a guy of his size.
Rajay Davis is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. Lester gets the sign. 1-0 on its way. And back-to-back pitches out of the zone to begin the evening. It's 2-0 now. And we'll need to keep the hot chocolate flowing tonight. 42 degrees our game time temperature. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
And you know what? These days, so many guys are throwing in the high 90s. It makes those mid to low 90s guys look easy. But I'll tell you what, if he mixes his pitches well, it can still be plenty fast to have to deal with.
Drilled down the line. And a reach to his backhand, but he can't come up with it, and the leadoff man's aboard.
Oh, it's just so important for a visiting ball club to come out swinging in the first inning. You got to do what you can do to get on the board first. And he gives him a good shot at that right here as he kicks off the night with a leadoff double.
Jason Kipnis will come forward now. And as you see by the numbers, he's off to a hot start here in the Fall Classic.
Yeah, you know some guys just love being on that big stage. And he's been a big part of this ball club all season long. So it's no surprise to me that he swung a hot bat when it matters the most.
First delivery to him on the way. Cut fastball taken for strike one.
And against a guy like this, you're usually only going to get one pitch to hit in that bat. Sometimes you might not even get that, so that's one he may want back.
That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
Up at the plate, you've got to be thinking right side, but you know, these guys are no dummies out there. They likely won't put anything in a location where he can pull it easily.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. To 2-2 now.
Oh, now there's a location you want right there. If that ball gets hit, you're just going to bang it into the ground all night long.
And now the runner's trying for third. Pitch outside. The throw. And there will be no throw as he takes third with ease. So this doesn't look good for now as he's going to come out with what looks like an injury to his back. Could be a number of things, and we're hoping it's not something that keeps him out for an extended period. Jorge Soler will have to come on and take over behind the plate after the injury.
Now catching, number 68, Jorge Soler.
Full count here. Here comes the pitch. Right side, hit hard. And there's a base hit, and the Tribe are going to strike first in this one. It's 1-0. Stepping in, Francisco Lindor. He'll get to take his first cuts here. He's set. Here it comes. And that's in there for strike one.
Oh, it's so important to be able to strike first in a postseason game. Get that first run in, especially when you're the team playing on the road. Hopefully you can take a little life out of this big crowd.
And boy, they're really giving him fits inside now as he can't get extended there, and it's 0-2 now. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike three called, one away.
Boy, and just a great call that time to turn to the changeup. That's one of those at the plate where you don't even wait for the umpire to make the call. You know you're a goner.
Mike Napoli steps in with one in, one out, and one on here in the inning.
Yeah, it's been a pretty good inning here so far, so we'll see if they can scratch another run across right here.
Down the third baseline. Well, this is foul for the first strike. One pitch on its way. There goes the runner. Pitches a called strike. The throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease. One out and a runner on second base. Too high. One and two. He took second fairly easily. Any thought of third base here?
I don't think so. You've got a good hitter at the plate. A single is probably all he needs. I'd let him try to drive you in.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Fowler is there now, and he has it. Two gone. Carlos Santana, the hitter now with a chance to pick up that runner from second with two away.
And this could prove to be a huge at-bat in this game because you don't want to let these type of scoring opportunities slip away early.
So let's take a peek at our umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Clyde Washington.
Yeah, Matt, Clyde has a bit of a reputation for rewarding pitchers that pound the bottom of the zone. He calls the game well, but we might see some strike calls below the zone that hitters aren't going to be too happy with.
And another foul ball. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And a good two-strike pitch, but he misses high, 1-2. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
Has to be thinking strikeout here. Skied into straightaway right. Hayward moves over. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. And now time to check how Joe Maddon has lined the Cubbies up in this one. Eric Karros, who you focused on?
Yeah, you know, you have to be careful with Daddy Longlegs himself, Dexter Fowler. I think he does a great job of taking what's given to him. Never tries to do too much. Knows how to extend an at-bat and get the pitch he's looking for.
Trevor Bauer gets the call in Game 5 of the series. EK, what do you got?
Remember, Matty, he throws both a four-seamer and a cutter. That four-seamer will just ride through the zone. That cutter will dart a little bit, makes it real tough for the hitters.
With a moment now, let's give you a look at how the Tribe stacks up defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, this manager loves to do the defensive shifts, so we're going to see a lot of odd formations as the game goes along. I can't wait to see how it works.
Well, there you see Dexter Fowler, as he'll be the one to commence the action in the bottom half of the first. Line towards center field. Davis is there, and he has it for the first out.
First pitch swinging here to start the inning, and he didn't waste any time waiting for his pitch. He got it right there. Just hit it right at somebody.
Chris Bryant will get a shot here, and he's looking to get off the schneid, hitless in the series so far.
And he's an important guy to get going. If they're going to have any chance in this series, he really needs to start getting a little more involved.
Hit hard on the ground towards second. A dive, but he can't get it. It's through into the outfield.
Yeah, he hit a good pitch there. This thing's toward the outside part of the plate, but he stays with it all the way. Uses the big part of the field and gets himself a base hit.
Anthony Rizzo stands in now as the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. Fastball at 94 miles an hour and it's 1-1. Runners on first with one down. Runners off for second. Pitches a cold strike. The throw. And he got him at second on a perfect throw. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. One hit's all they get. Second inning coming up here at Wrigley. The Indians on top, 1-0. Jose Ramirez. Opportunity here, and if you go by the numbers, it's been a disappointing start to this World Series for him so far.
Yeah, he really hasn't gotten on track, and I think you have to give some of that credit to good pitching, but he's really been a bit of a non-factor so far. Still time for him to turn it around, though.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
And, you know, I think it's going to be important that when guys get their pitches, they take advantage. There it looked like he was taken all the way, and he may not get another pitch that catches that much of the plate.
Lester's ready, coming at him with the 0-1. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and the leadoff man set down to start the second.
Batting seven. The right fielder, number six.
Into the box now, Brandon Guyer, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Into the windup and the pitch. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Yeah, a little unlucky here to be behind 2-0. Those first couple of pitches haven't missed by a whole lot.
3-0 now. At the very least, he certainly established the inside part of the plate.
Yeah, but it's not going to do him a whole lot of good if none of those can find the strike zone.
In tight as this pitch misses, and it's a four-pitch walk. Roberto Perez takes his first shot here with a runner at first now and one away. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike. Runner at first here, one man out. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Zobrist is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. And with two away now, let's take another look at our playoff brackets. And, of course, the question on everybody's mind, will we crown a champion here tonight? Trevor Bauer stands in for the first time. And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. Good hard sinker that time, and he's in control 0-2. Boy, tough enough to be an American League pitcher swinging the bat as it is. How about having to deal with pitches like that?
One word, Matty, unfair.
Hayward is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. One left for the Tribe, who played an inning and a half. It's 1-0. Ben Zobrist will dig in now, and he's picked the wrong time of year for his bat to go silent.
Yeah, just one hit in the series so far for him, and they're going to have to get more out of his bat. But he's got to make sure he doesn't press up there, or that average is going to continue to go south.
And the 34-year-old veteran looks at a called strike. It's 0-1.
Oh, that's a thing of beauty right there.
Strike two on the curveball. 0-2.
Oh, yeah. You know, he went backdoor breaking ball with the previous pitch. Then he's got him set up to come down and in with the next one, and he throws a curl right there.
Throw on to first in time, one away.
Batting fifth.
Addison Russell settles into the box for his first chance. And he'll try and crowd him there with a fastball to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. I think he took a little exception to that location.
Yeah, and so would I if I was down there. If you want to work inside, that's fine. But once you get up over the letters and closer to my head, now we're talking about a different story.
Hitters count. Here's the 2-0 pitch. A strike, and it's 2-1.
Yeah, you know, he probably got the fastball he was looking for, but on 2-0, you can look for one pitch in one spot. And if it's not in that spot, you take it.
Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. Around first, on his way to second now. And he'll cruise into the bag at second with a one-out double. So striding in, Jason Hayward, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Cut fastball in there for a called strike. Runner at second here with one man out. And he misses with it, 1-1.
Well, that's not a real favorable call for him right here. It's one thing when you're facing a lightweight hitter up there, but facing a guy like this, the difference between 1-1 and 0-2 is huge.
Close pitch, but just a bit outside. He wanted it, but it's 2-1. There's the cold strike he was looking for, 2-2 now.
A little conviction behind that fastball.
Liner towards second, but there to take this one is the second baseman, and that's out number two.
Well, this is just kind of a little soft humpback liner, and these look like the easiest plays in the world, but Eric will tell you, sometimes a ball can knuckle on you a little bit. It didn't happen to him right there, and that's an easy play.
Javier Baez will get a chance here, and you see the numbers for the series. He just has not gotten going yet.
Now, and if they're going to get back in this series, they're going to need him to get back in the groove because this pitching staff has buried him so far.
Here's the first pitch to him. First offering to him stays upstairs. It's a ball and no strikes. And he misses again, 2-0. Here it comes, 2-0. Too high. And it's 3-0. Swinging away, and now the count will be 3-1. Three balls and a strike. Here's the pitch. Now a swing and a ball lofted down the right field line and fairly deep. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. One left for the Cubs. They trail this one 1-0. Back to the top of the order now, and stepping in is the center fielder, Rajay Davis.
Rajay Davis.
And a high strike there, 0-1.
Yeah, I don't think you want to come in throwing a lot of high changeups. That's a pitch he's going to have to get lower in the strike zone.
Swing and a liner. Foul. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Well, you're always gunning for a strikeout when he's at the plate because his legs make him so dangerous, even when he hits just a slow grounder. So nice job of keeping him off base right there.
And is the second baseman, Jason Kipnis. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And this is going to wind up a foul ball.
You know, some of Jason Kipnis' teammates affectionately call him Dirtbag because he has a habit of giving his body up and getting his uniform dirty on every play. And you got to love a guy like that.
Can't quite get around in time to keep it fair, and it remains 0-2. Well, with all the bases Kipnis is capable of stealing, it's no surprise why his uniform is so dirty all the time. He stole more than 30 in 2012 and 13, 22 bags in 2014.
Yeah, and not quite as many steals in 2015, but his overall production.
Meanwhile here, this ball's given a pretty good ride out to deep left field, and that is going to clear the wall, a home run. It's a solo homer here for Jason Kipnis. His second home run of the series. And with it, the Indians have taken a 2-0 lead.
Now batting.
So here's Francisco Lindor now.
Lindor.
As he'll swing and send a line drive out to right field. A screaming base hit here, his first of the night.
And when you see a guy rip one like this, one pitch after the previous guy left the yard, you know you're dealing with a pitcher whose mind is elsewhere. That'll snap you back to reality, though, pretty quick.
Mike Napoli is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1.
Oh, that is a nice pitch right there. You kind of slow it down and give him that big breaking ball to start off the at-bat. Make sure he's not a guy that's looking to ambush that first pitch fastball.
Around third and being waved on home. In to score is the runner from first. It's a 3-0 game. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Carlos Santana. He flew out in his last at bat. Lifted in the air out to center field. Fowler over to his left, and he makes the catch for the second out. Settling in now, Jose Ramirez. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
And I think that's been a big part of the problem so far. He just can't locate his fastball, especially in situations where he has to.
Fastball at 94 miles an hour, and it's 1-1.
Right back inside with a fastball. This time, he got the call.
In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now. Out in front as this is skied in the air to straightaway left. He can't track it down as this ball falls. And they're going to hold that runner at third base, as even with two away, they didn't like their chances there. Brandon Guyer steps into the box, and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home in the inning so far. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Swung on and missed on a pitch at the thumbs, a ball and a strike. In there, 1-2 now. hit the other way out toward right field. On the move is Hayward. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on four base hits, no errors, and a couple of men left on. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. The Tribe lead this one 3-0. Leading off the inning, Jorge Soler, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. Bauer's ready. Here's the first pitch. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
And you know, you get stuck sometimes being that number eight hitter, trying to work the count and trying to buy a little extra time for your pitcher. Now that's a pitch right down the middle that maybe a number four hitter jumps all over.
All right, guys, we're going to check this sequence out again on ShowTrack, but I can guarantee you he doesn't want to see it again. He's got this thing all backwards up there. He looks at the first two pitches. Those are pitches he probably should have swung at. Then he swings at the one pitch that's out of the strike zone.
Standing in now, John Lester. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Dexter Fowler stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one.
Boy, he may strike out the side on nine pitches. Seven down, two to go.
Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. Two out, nobody on. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Kipnis has it. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Nothing doing here this half. We've played three here in game number five. It's the Indians 3 and the Cubs nothing. Roberto Perez is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
And they jumped out to that early lead, so now it's all about just adding on.
Lester into his motion. First pitch on its way. And a first pitch sinker is over for strike one.
And you kind of wonder if he's learned anything out there. There's another pitch right down the middle. I think he's lucky that that one didn't get hit a long way.
And he pumps the fastball by him at 94. It's 0-2. Turned on down the line. But a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Half swing here, but it won't matter. It's strike three called anyway, and that's out number one. Trevor Bauer is at the plate now, flied out in his first at-bat. And there's the good fastball from Lester as he jumps ahead. No balls and a strike. And he falls behind 0-2. He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Got him. Into the box, Rajay Davis. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yep, they sent him packing last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea.
Slide and a stop by Baez. Got him.
Woo, no problem.
So they're held in check here this half of the inning. To the bottom of inning number four we go. It's the Indians 3 and the Cubs nothing. Leading off the inning, Chris Bryant. And they'll need him to get something going here.
And in a pretty close game so far, they'd love to see this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing.
And a cut fastball in there for a strike. It's 0-1. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now. Chop foul over towards the dugout. Tapped out in front of home. Perez scoops it up, throws in time, and that's out number one.
First baseman.
So one gone in the inning, and that'll bring up the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time.
And you know what, guys? I've been really impressed so far. Not only has he used his fastball well, but he's also spotted it well. I mean, that is perfect location, right on the knees.
Ball swung on and hit high down the line in left, but it'll get back in among the crowd, so the count holds at 0-2. Trying to strike him out for the second time. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. Very weakly on the ground. That goes foul, so he stays alive with two strikes. Got him swinging in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Rizzo is retired, two down now. Ben Zobrist will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Now a curveball that misses here to the cleanup man. It's 1-0. And a strike to even the count. 1-1.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
This now is hit to second. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. Eight in a row he's set down, and the side is... Jason Kipper, the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. And he lays off for a ball. 2-1. He's fallen behind now. 3-1.
You figure he should get something good to hit here. They don't want to walk him and put him on for the heart of the order.
Hit hard on the ground to second. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. Francisco Lindor will stand in. A strikeout victim his first time and then a base hit last time around. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him. Mike Napoli steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And he comes after the next guy as well. Can't say I like what I'm seeing here. It's ball one.
Well, don't expect him to forget throwing inside, even after the hit by pitch. He just won't start giving in to guys out there.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
You wonder if hitting that last hitter may have rattled him a little. He's having an awfully hard time finding the strike zone now.
And he lays off here. A nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away. Lester sets. Here's the first pitch. Carlos Santana stands in as he looks at ball one here. And that last pitch was number 74 for Lester in this one. And, oh, looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1.
Tonight, borderline calls, you got to be swinging.
Breaking ball snaps in there for a called strike two.
Yeah, and it seems like he kind of got away from that pitch here in the last few innings. You got to think about bringing that one right back.
That one misses, and I think a ballpark full of umpires disagrees. It's 2-2. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls. Jose Ramirez will dig in. One for two. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. He's set. Here's the 0-1. Chop foul over towards the coaching box. Three runs, six hits. No errors to this point for the Indians. And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
And he didn't want that one to be in the strike zone. Even with the bases loaded, this is still a strikeout situation, remember.
To two balls and two strikes now. Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2. I'll tell you, he's already hit one guy. He is not afraid to work inside.
No, and as much as I hate to say it, pitchers have just as much right to the inside part of the plate as you do.
Fowler will make the play. Tagging is the runner from third. And the run will cross on the sack fly and make it a 4-0 game.
Well, that's all he's hoping to do right here. Just get that thing airborne and get that first run of the game home. He does his job. Picks up the RBI.
Pitch swung on and hit in the air. On the move is Fowler. He gets there, but he missed it. And they'll extend their lead even further as the runs in to score from third. The runner from first crosses the plate. Roberto Perez will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that... Addison Russell will stand in to lead things off here, and his guys have been unable to get anything going to this point.
Yeah, and you think so many times in the postseason, we see starting pitching really come to the forefront. And this guy's been every bit as good as advertised so far.
And there's ball one.
Well, one thing we've seen from this guy on the mound so far, when he makes bad pitches, they typically miss out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
And he'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate with the fastball as he backs him off a bit. Fastball is looked at for strike two.
2-2.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Swing and a liner. Foul. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Hard hit ball to second. Kipnis is there and taken in out there for the first out.
The right fielder number 22.
Jason Hayward stands in for the second time. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, he put a good swing on it last time, so we'll see if he can make one fall here.
First pitch is a cutter looked at, 0-1. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. One and two now. Bases are empty, one man out. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. Napoli's there, and he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
Second baseman, number nine.
Javier Baez is into the box for his second appearance. 0-for-1 with a flyout. And he lays off there, 1-0.
Well on his way to another good inning right here, and you see the pitch count. It's not even close to being a factor just yet.
And that's too high, ball two. Bases are empty here with two men out. Outside, 3-0 now. Figure he's taken now on the three-ball count.
Maybe even taken two.
Now ball hit foul down the line in right and in amongst the fans. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Fly ball heading for the alley. Guyer giving chase. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. And he will stroll in there standing with a two-out double.
Well, this is a good fastball hitting team. And if you put these guys in a position where they can afford to just sit on fastballs, they're going to have a lot of success. And sure enough, he gets ahead in the count, he gets himself that fastball, and then he drives it for two bases. This is easy, isn't it?
In is Jorge Soler. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Two out here and a runner at second. In the dirt here, but fortunately here, no advance. The 2-0 pitch. In the dirt, it's 3-0 now.
Yeah, it looked like he was well on his way to a quick inning, but now a hit and a 3-0 count have turned the tables on that idea.
And he gets this fastball over, back to 3-1 now.
And this is the thing that's so impressive about this guy. He'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. Miguel Montero is into the on-deck circle now as he'll pinch hit for the pitcher, Lester.
Miguel Montero.
Cut fastball taken for strike one.
Good pitch right there, right on the heels of a walk. He needed to get ahead of the next guy, and he did just that.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Yeah, one pitch away now from getting through five shutout innings. And I'll tell you what, the way he's throwing, this could turn out to be a night off for the bullpen.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Travis Wood will come on now to try and sort this mess out as he'll likely be asked to go at least a few innings here. Trevor Bauer comes to the plate now, likely due to the large cushion he has to work with on the scoreboard. And he takes a cold strike, 0-1. Swing and a miss, and he's in control, 0-2. Woods ready. Here's the 0-2. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Rajay Davis will step in. A ground out victim his last time.
Yeah, ground out last time. But you know, with his speed, that's kind of a big part of the way he plays the game. Put the ball on the ground and force the defense to make a clean, quick play on him. Because if they don't, he's safe.
And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter. This is strike two anyway.
Yeah, that pitch is still up a little bit, but at least this one was out on a corner. But I don't think I'd want to be making a living up there too much.
And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. And this will wind up being nothing more than a long foul ball, and it'll hold the count at 0-2. Two-seamer can't quite make it back over the plate. It's a ball and two strikes.
Well, you know, when you're behind an account like this, it's all about changing your approach at the plate. You got to shorten up a little bit and just look to put the ball in play.
Ready on 1-2. Line drive to center field. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. He'll take the turn and head for second. Around second, he'll try for third. And he is in there at third with a one-out triple. Jason Kipnis will stride in again. And before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Slapped hard the opposite way. But quick hands over there at third as he takes it for the second out.
Just a tough break right there. Not much you can do about that one. This ball is a laser, but it's right at his man. And that forces the guy to hold on at third with two away now.
Francisco Lindor is at the plate as he looks at ball one. And he watches a called strike as this one bears in on him. 1-1. He goes the other way as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Dexter Fowler will stand in to start things off as this top of the batting order hasn't found a whole lot of success so far.
In fact, just one hit between the 1-2-3 hitters combined. So apparently the table setters have not been getting their chores done.
Throw to first is in time for the first out.
Sometimes this is all you have to do. Throw a ton of strikes and keep the ball in the yard. It's worked for him so far.
Chris Bryant stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. 1-0 pitch on the way. In for a strike, it's 1-1.
And if he's had any postseason jitters, he hasn't shown them to me.
No, he's been outstanding so far.
That's in there on the outer half, 1-2 now.
Seems like it's been a fairly consistent pattern. Hard stuff early, soft stuff late. But these guys don't seem to have caught on yet.
It's a pretty standard operating procedure, too. But they just look lost up there.
Ooh, he saws him off with that one. And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two. Anthony Rizzo, ready to take another shot, went down on strikes his last time up.
Yeah, they got him on a breaking ball, so now we'll see if they try to put him away with soft stuff again if they get that chance.
Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Called strike at the knees, 1-1.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
And that gets down, and we'll see if that's extra bases. Rizzo will head for second. And he'll make it in there with a two-out double.
Well, this is one of the few mistakes he's made all game long. Not too many guys have made solid contact so far, but he squared that one up pretty well.
Ben Zobrist will step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, and it's been a long time coming. They haven't done anything with their opportunities so far. Maybe this will be the time that they finally crack the scoreboard.
The 1-0 delivery. Just missing here, 2-0. Looks like he's not going to see anything here.
Yeah, I don't think so either. They gave him two shots to see if he'd go out of the zone to try to chase. And after that, I'm thinking they should just put him on.
That one's more like it, he says. Back to 2-1 now. From the belt, kicks and deals. In there, and it's even now, 2-2.
A strike away now from getting through six shutout innings here, and that's no small feat against this lineup.
To the right side, but foul, and he'll try it again. Now a swing as he pulls this one down the line and right. In there, a base hit. Around third and being waved on home. And the runner scores from second as they cut away into that deficit here. It's a 6-1 game.
Well, time for another old baseball cliche. It's a game of inches. And it was on this ball. Take a look at how close this is to the foul line. And this is not a fair ball by a whole lot, but I guarantee you he'll take it. He pulls into second with an RBI double.
Geyer racing back, but he won't get there as it lands just shy of the wall. And the runner from second is in to score. That makes it a 6-2 game.
I feel like I've seen this before. That is three straight doubles now.
How often do you see that? He's going to drive in another run here as the big inning continues.
Here's Jason Hayward now, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. So the three straight hits have that man right there perhaps assessing his options.
Three straight two-out hits, too. That makes any move a little more complicated.
And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's 1-1. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Chopped foul at the plate, and we'll do it again. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Grounded up the first baseline. Two runs, six hits. One error for the Cubs to this point. Goes the other way with it as this is in the air down the line and left. And Santana will put the squeeze on this one, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left. Welcome back here to the historic friendly confines of Wrigley Field. It's on to the seventh now in game number five. But before the inning gets underway, let's fill you in on what's happened with our game summary. Mike Napoli is in to start things out as he swings and misses at that one at strike one.
Yeah, that's a very hittable location right there. Not where you want to be when you're facing a guy like this.
Hit sharply on the ground. Carlos Santana stands in, trying to change his evil ways here. Hitless in the ballgame so far. Squared that one up just a little late. Wood sets. 0-1 pitch on its way. Here's a late swing and a miss. Strike two. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Fouled back. Nobody out, runner on first. Swing and a flare hit toward right. And that'll get down for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. Digging in now, Jose Ramirez earned himself an RBI with a sac fly his last time at the plate. Called strike at the letters, 0-1.
Now with two on, nobody out, you got to be thinking strikeout double play out there on the mound. One or the other is what you really need.
Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's 1-1. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Back up the middle, and that'll get through. It's into center, a base hit. And no sense risking anything here as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out. Brandon Guyer will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far.
Yeah, guys, he's got to be feeling a little bit like that dog that gets left out in the rain while the rest of the family's inside by the fire. I guess he's just not seeing what everyone else is.
That's wide, 2-0.
Well, you know, three straight hits are bad enough, but now he's making things even worse by falling behind the next guy.
Now a swing and an easy fly ball out toward right center. Calling for it, Hayward, one down. And they will not try anything here, so the bases remain loaded with one away. Roberto Perez comes to the plate with the bases juiced, and it seems a big hit here could really put this one out of reach. Now a fastball as he has to lean out of the way there. Oh, and he comes after him again there. Ball two.
Yeah, and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
3-0 now.
Take sign? That would be a take sign.
Taking all the way that time. It's 3-1.
And even 3-1, I say take another one.
And a called strike on the outside corner there. It's full now, 3-2.
Taken again on 3-1. He's trying to get that RBI the easy way, but now they've worked it back to a full count.
He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third. Trevor Bauer will stand in now with the bases loaded, two away, and a chance to really help himself out.
And at the very least, he's got to focus on getting something in play. He can really help himself out with just a simple single here.
A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. High in the air out to center field. Fowler shading to his right, and the inning is over. Three left for the Indians. They lead it. Javier Baez steps into the box as the leadoff hitter here in the bottom of the seventh.
Boy, they've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game. So just chip away, chip away.
And this is going to find the alley as he might have himself his second double of the ballgame. And a very quick start to the inning here. It's a first pitch double. Digging in, Jorge Soler. He drew a walk his first time up. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And he starts the number 8 hitter with a strike. Nothing in one.
I think a lot of pitching coaches would like to see that first pitch strike ratio better than about 60%. But that's what he's got going for him tonight. And he's pitched very well.
And he reaches for one out of the zone and misses rather badly for the first out. Kyle Schwarber will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 12, Kyle Schwarber.
In there at the knees, strike one. EK, the starter, creeping up on 100 pitches now, but that number alone doesn't appear to be affecting him too much at all.
Yeah, he still looks sharp. Still, with the way that teams handle pitchers nowadays, I don't think he'll wind up going much further.
Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes. Little tap. And that is off the first base bag. Napoli comes up with it.
And when you're coming off the bench, the rule is get on base any way you can. And the last time I checked, an infield single meets those requirements. It's not pretty, but he'll take it.
Dexter Fowler will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0-3 thus far. A little late on this one as it's lifted the other way down the left field line. Santana is there. Let's see if they test it. And it'll be a sack fly and an RBI as that'll cut this to a 3-run deficit now. Chris Bryant gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in 3 tries to this point. Here comes the first pitch. Good changeup there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one.
And for all the pitches he's thrown, only one walk so far. That's a little bit surprising.
And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. 2 hits in the inning lead to a run for Chicago. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. It's the Indians 6 and the Cubbies 3. Aroldis Chapman will be summoned from the bullpen now as he'll take over to start inning number 8. Rajay Davis is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Chapman has the target. Here's the 0-1. And now Davis swings and misses on a good pitch there as he falls behind 0-2 now. Very difficult to get on top of a pitch when it's coming in that high.
Darn near impossible when it's coming at you in the high 90s. You just can't get your hands up there fast enough to stay on top.
And the 8th inning begins with a flyout. Quickly one away. Jason Kipnis is set to take some more swings. He homered back in the 3rd inning. First offering on its way. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one.
Hard to call that an off-speed pitch when it's a changeup at 88. That's a fastball for a lot of guys in this league.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Everything away here, and with pretty good reason.
Yeah, they'll say left field, it's all yours. You want to beat us that way, go ahead and do it.
3-1 now. And the count will be full. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Kipnis takes, and this pitch misses for ball four. It's a free pass. Francisco Lindor will stand in. He flew out his last time up.
Francisco Lindor.
And a high strike there, 0-1.
And after a walk, I think there's a little anger behind that fastball.
1-1.
One ball.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. The pitch, a fastball off his glove, and it bounds away. And he'll make it in easily at second, as I'd imagine that'll be scored a passed ball. A full count, three balls and two strikes. In danger now of a second walk out of the bullpen.
Not exactly providing relief. He's got to find it here somehow.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Up next for Cleveland,
Mike Napoli, ready for another at-bat now. He's 2-for-3 so far.
Yeah, and you can bet he'd love to get himself that third hit. Those are the kind of games that puts a little extra pep in your step.
That's inside. 2-0.
Well, he almost hit him on the last pitch, and he's showing he doesn't care. He's coming right back inside.
And this one's over at the knees, 2-1. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two.
You can see where they want to go to try and get him out. A lot of pitches in on the hands in this sequence. They don't want him to be able to extend.
And this gets right through him, and that may be a run. And on the error, a run is going to score. And he is in there. Carlos Santana digs in, coming off a single in his last at-bat. First pitch coming, here it is. Slider, and it's off his glove, and it bounces away. And he'll make it to third here on what will likely be ruled a passed ball. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Crowds him a bit with a fastball there, and it's to 1-1. Hit hard down the line, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Nope, now a slider can't make it back to that outside edge, and that takes the count to 2-2 now.
Yeah, and when that pitch starts off outside, it's much easier to get a better view of it and then just lay off.
And he comes back with one down and in for ball three. And he got him. Minimizing the damage at just a run, the inning is over. Indians forced to settle for one. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. It's the Indians 7 and the Cubbies 3. Danny Salazar is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth. Leading off the inning, Anthony Rizzo. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Well, you're facing a pretty big deficit in this game, so they need to start clawing their way back.
And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. High in the air into shallow left center. Santana over to his right, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
The batter.
Now in the box, Ben Zobrist, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
And we all know he's a much better hitter from the other side.
Starts him out with a slider for a strike. Hit to short. Lindor over to his left. Throw on to Nathalie, takes care of him. Two away now. Addison Russell will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
And this pitch just about saws him off as he can't get extended at all. It's strike one.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Right, especially starting off an at-bat.
And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Late making contact on that swing, and will do it again on 1-2. 1-2, here it comes. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Bago with a great view of downtown as we're set here to start the ninth inning from Wrigley Field. Jose Ramirez ready for another at bat now. He's 2-for-3 so far. Here we go with inning number 9 as the first pitch misses for ball one. Two and oh now. Late swing on the hitter's count. Still a good count for him now, however, at 2-1. Chapman's ready. Here's the 2-1. Yanked on the ground down the line. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Chopped foul right at home plate. All even at 2-2. Here it is. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. A quick out number one.
Now batting.
You see here on show track, that pitch up and in just ties him in knots. If you leave that out over the plate, you'll be in trouble, but if you can locate there, things will be just fine.
Brandon Guyer comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Swing and he pops him up. Looks to be playable in foul ground. And the catch is made there. Two gone here in the ninth.
The catcher, number 55.
Roberto Perez digs in. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
And that was a huge strikeout at the time because there were two runners in scoring position. And it's never fun to walk back to the dugout knowing that you left RBIs on the table.
Here it comes, 1-0. This one's a strike. It's 1-1.
Corner paint right there, 97 miles an hour. What are you going to do with that?
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Ripped on the ground to first. Onto the bag with it is Rizzo, and the inning is over. Jason Hayward will be the one to start things off with his galley here if this series is going to make it to a game six. And here's a fastball called for strike one. They'll ride the hot hand on the mound as this man will stay out there after the 1-2-3 inning last time around.
And the more important set of numbers is that he got that 1-2-3 against the guys hitting in the middle of the lineup, 3, 4, and 5. So now as a reward, he'll get to match up with the bottom portion of the lineup here.
To first, Napoli is there. And he'll take this to the bag, 3 unassisted for the first out. Javier Baez will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs.
Yeah, and you just can't worry about the score right here. You just got to be able to string together a couple of base runners and take it one pitch at a time, one runner at a time.
Late decision to swing that time, and as a result, it's 0-2. Lifted down the line and right and back out of play. Count holds it 0-2. And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now. Jorge Soler will stand in, and their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out. Called a strike on the outer half, 0-1. Swing and a little tapper. That winds up foul for the second strike. And that's going to do it. It's all over, and the Indians are the world champs.
And you know what? I bet the only thing they wish they could have done a little bit differently is win this thing in front of their home crowd. But you know what? I don't think anyone's complaining about that right now. They are a very deserving world championship club, and congratulations to the entire organization.
Back now on the show. It's all over, and you see the reactions there to the final out. And down on the field, we'll get a chance to watch the presentation of the Commissioner's Trophy to the new world champs.